In 2 days, two local soldiers lose their lives in the Middle East. Today, we're learning more about their service and their lives outside the military. Good afternoon. I'm Lisa Cooney. These soldiers died in two separate events. Most recent, we learned about Private First Class Russell Madden. The 29-year-old father and husband was killed this week when his convoy came under attack. News 5's Terry Daniels is live from his hometown in Bellevue, Kentucky, to tell us more about how he's being remembered. Terry?
Well, Lisa, I'm actually at the Bellevue High School football team. This is where Russell Madden played for a number of years. You might notice the flag here has been lowered to half staff. And right here, a second flag has been added to this stone in memory of Justin Scott. He was another Bellevue grad who was killed in Afghanistan back in 2004. Now, over at the high school, the flag is also flying at half staff to honor Russell Madden, who was killed yesterday in Afghanistan. The 29-year-old graduated in the year 2000. He played on the football team as well as participated in other sports. He was married and had two young sons. A little while ago, I talked to a coach who actually graduated with him and one of his former teachers. Here's how they remember him.
He was always the fun guy to be around. He could always make anybody laugh in any situation. And you know, he was just the kind of lighthearted guy that you really always wanted around, because you know with him that you're going to laugh sooner or later.
He was an energetic kid, always had a smile on his face, you know, and it was contagious. He was able to carry that smile and spread it with everybody around him. Always energetic, always on the move, just a bundle of energy. And you can tell he was just full of life.
Well, Russell Madden's wife, Michelle, is right now flying to Delaware. That's where she will pick up the body and accompany it back here to Bellevue for his funeral. Reporting live in Bellevue, Kentucky, Terry Daniels, News 5.
So sad, Terry.